Hey, what up? It's Woolmaker. Today I'm going to go over using FL Studio as a plugin in Ableton. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. So the first way that I use this is when I want to use an FL Studio sound in my Ableton session. First, I'm going to highlight my MIDI track in Ableton. You can either search FL or Image Line, or come over here to the AUV2, then just go down to Image Line and add FL Studio. Then you're going to get this pop-up. Now, I set my time offset to 4. This sets how many bars FL Studio should start playing before Ableton plays. Next, I'm going to click the Fruity Umbrella. Now you'll see the FL Studio launches in Ableton. Next, I'm going to go to Options and Audio Settings. I make sure to check Slave Tempo. I think some new terminology should be used nowadays, but that's just me. Checking this will allow FL to follow Ableton's tempo. Next, I'm just going to clear everything in the channel rack. In order to do that, I'm just going to click and drag here. Come up here, delete selected. Next, you can just replace this or add an instrument. I'm just going to add flex. Now, in order to hear your instrument play with your MIDI controller, your instrument needs to be on top here. So put your mouse over the instrument and just scroll up. So now you can hear your instrument. Now go ahead and just click the Fruity Umbrella again. And now you can use Flex in Ableton. The next way I use this is if I want to route an FL session into Ableton, and you can route up to 16 tracks. So if you wanted to create your drum pattern in FL because you like the piano roll better, you can do that. Or in this case, I'm just going to route a song that I used the new stem separation feature on. So follow the same steps and just add FL to a MIDI track. Click the Fruity Umbrella. So go ahead and import your sample. Click up here. We're going to extract stems from sample. Extract which parts you want. Extract. I really wish that it went that fast. Once extracted, I'm going to assign these two mixer tracks. Now I'm going to head to the mixer window. Now in the mixer window, I'm going to highlight my first track. Head over to audio output target. I'm going to assign this to FL2, FL3, etc. Make sure that you select pattern or song mode. Now I'm going to click on the Fruity Umbrella. Back in Ableton, I'm going to create a few more audio tracks. Now you're going to head to Audio From, and you're going to select FL Studio. Then I'm going to select FL2, FL3, FL4, FL5. Make sure Monitor In is selected. Now I can mute the main track so I don't have both sources playing. Once you've selected Monitor In, your session or drum pattern should be routed. Now if I want, I can just record this by just hitting record, or I can just mix this now if I choose. You can also use the resample feature in Ableton if you don't need the session on separate tracks. So those are two ways that I use FL Studio as a VST in Ableton. This also works in any other DAWs that support VST format. So if you like content like this, please feel free and like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.